Certainly, I don't need to say much about the benefits of the golden ratio in life, especially in art. In this video, I will guide you on designing a professional logo based on the golden ratio grid. First, let's spend 30 seconds creating the golden ratio grid. Draw a square of any size. Hold the Alt key to copy a similar square below. Continue drawing a square next to it with a side length equal to the sum of two squares. Repeat this to draw the next squares. Next, draw circles inside each square. Now you've completed the golden ratio grid, and you can scale it up or down without worrying about changing the proportions. I'll copy four circles to the side for the design. Then group this grid and hide it. I'll create two diagonals at a 45-degree angle to capture points when moving the circles. Change them to orange for better visibility. As you know, to precisely position a circle, you need two points of contact on the circle or one point in the center. For a straight line, you need two points on the line or one point at an angle. Here, I'll highlight the points of contact to help you understand better. First, I'll move the smallest circle to create the bird's head. Move the third circle to create the bird's wing. To move at a 45-degree angle, hold the Shift key and move the mouse at the desired angle. Move the second circle for the other wing. Continue moving the second circle to complete the body. I noticed that when drawing the tail, if I draw a straight line, the distance between the tail and the wings is too large. So, I'll tilt it slightly. Let's try 16 degrees. It's too close. So, 12 degrees should do it. You can see that having a slight angle in the tail gives a better visual balance with the angled wings, making the bird's flight appear more natural. Use the line with the same angle to create the bird's beak. By this point, has anyone imagined the image of the bird yet? If not, you'll see it right after I use the live paint bucket tool. Note that you shouldn't leave the fill color empty. Here, I'll press Shift plus X to swap the stroke and fill colors. Normally, I would clean up the grid lines so that when using the live paint bucket tool, it doesn't create too many anchor points, but I'll skip that step in this tutorial. Then, expand, ungroup, and delete the grid. Now, let's add text to the logo. That's it. Take a look at the logo's grid. If you want to learn how to animate a grid like this, I have a tutorial video linked in the description for you to check out. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to like, share, or leave a comment below to let me know, and I'll make more similar videos in the future.